Good afternoon and we're live. It is 12 noon and we're here in County Wicklow for the Student Enterprise Programme Finals. We're live on Facebook, we're live on YouTube and you're all very, very welcome. So the comments are open and Alpha Boutique are in already. So there's Hannah Flew saying she's so excited. So give a shout out for your school, for your friends, for your colleagues who are all in for nominations for this afternoon's awards. We're here for about an hour and we have a packed show for you. And when I say we have a packed show, we have not one, but two really, really special surprise guests. I can't believe who's going to turn up here today. So I won't steal the thunder on it. Stay tuned and we'll have a couple of surprises for you. So sit back, relax, get involved in the chat and we'll kick things off with the Cathaoirleacht of Wicklow County Council, Pat Kennedy, to open proceedings. Pat, over to you.
Good afternoon. It is my pleasure as Cathaoirleacht of Wicklow County Council to welcome you here today to a very different county final of the Student Enterprise Programme in 2021. As you have moved from classroom to online learning over the past 12 months, you have learned many important life skills, flexibility, adaptation and resilience in the face of obstacles. These key attributes are also necessary in order to succeed as an entrepreneur. By your presence here today, you have demonstrated your resilience and persistence, and I congratulate you for that. With the help of your teachers and programme coordinators, you have developed and run your own businesses, researching your market, developing a wide range of products and services which you successfully have marketed and sold online. The award ceremony today is an acknowledgement of your achievements. Irrespective of whether you leave with a prize or not, you should be proud of the way you have worked and succeeded in the face of adversity. Great credit is also due to your teachers, and I commend them for their role in nurturing the next generation of business leaders for County Wicklow. The local enterprise office and Wicklow County Council will be here to support you should you choose to continue your entrepreneurial journey into the future. But for now, well done to you, and all the best of luck to the winners today, who will represent Wicklow in the national final in May. Thank you.
And thank you, Cathaoirleacht. And we're off and running. So we have nearly 100 people on the live stream already, and you're very, very welcome. And please use the chat to leave positive comments and shout out to your team and your school. And we want to welcome everybody here today. So Noah has actually said that my mic is muted, but I've checked it and it's grand. But Ruth Lillis is on there. Good luck to all in Colashto Quavon. And we have a few more comments coming through and they're shouting out for everyone. We'll show those as we go on later on. So moving on. And we've had our Cathaoirleacht to open up the proceedings. And we're going to move to Frank Curran, the Chief Executive of Wicklow County Council, to say a few words.
Hello everybody, my name is Frank Curran, I am Chief Executive of Wicklow County Council. I'm delighted to be here today at the County Final of the Student Enterprise Award. This is the 20th anniversary of the Student Enterprise Award nationally, and currently each year over 26,000 students experience the highs and lows of entrepreneurship through this programme. Students get experience in relation to business planning, strategy, manufacturing, marketing and sales. It accords very well with the business studies programme at junior and senior cycle. In Wicklow, 16 students have taken part, 962 students, which is phenomenal given the current environment that we operate in. I would like to pay a special tribute to the local enterprise office, who have really embraced the concept of online learning. Live webinars, online chats, support in relation to online sales, in addition to the normal class-based mentoring. But in particular, I would like to pay tribute to the students who have really embraced the challenge that COVID-19 has presented to us. They've conducted their activities online in terms of meetings through Teams, and Zoom, and Skype. They've embraced online selling. They've embraced cashless payments. They've embraced selling services as opposed to focusing entirely on manufacturing. And all that is to be complimented. I think your parents and teachers should be extremely proud. And I would like to thank the parents and teachers for all the help that they have provided. But in particular, I would like to thank the students and congratulate you for what you have done. You are the entrepreneurs of the future, and everybody here is a winner. I would like to conclude by wishing those who progress in the competition the very best of luck. Thank you very much.
And thank you, Frank. So I'm going to move steadily along, and we're going to bring in the head of enterprise in local enterprise office in Wicklow, Vibeke Del Hunt. Vibeke, it's great to see you, and thank you for joining us. And I've seen a preview of some of the entries. I'm blown away this year by the quality and the amount of hard work that's gone in really difficult times. We've had 16 schools and just under 1,000 entries this year.
I know.
And have you had a chance to look at some of them yourself?
I did, Noel. I was going through them as we shared them with the judges, and I'm just so proud. This day, the Enterprise Awards, we're so in the Leo team, we're so fond of this day because it's always great buzz. We have all the students coming to Claremont here, and of course this year now we're online, and it's equally as exciting, and there's a good buzz about, and it's great to see all the comments coming in as well. But yeah, no, we're every year we're blown away by the range of different business ideas that people come up with, and it's great to see, you know, the creativity, the focus on climate change, and you know, just the breadth, and as she says, the breadth of the ideas, but also to get these numbers this year, you know, 16 schools, 962 students. Well done to you all. Like, it hasn't been easy, and definitely want to give a shout out to the teachers and the parents for all their backup and to make sure that you know, you stuck with it till the end. So well done to all the students, all the teachers, and maybe while I'm at it, no, can I also say a huge thank you to Gary and Hannah from WizKids, who are the coordinators for the Leo team on this program. And of course, in our own team, Annette Rosen, who organizes the Student Enterprise program throughout the year, who's a phenomenal eye for detail and is just absolutely an amazing team player. So thanks to everybody. But yeah, to come back to the businesses, brilliant. Absolutely just as good as every other year, if not better.
Yeah, and you know, they really, I think this year more than any previous year, they've really demonstrated true entrepreneurial spirit and that resilience that's required by entrepreneurs and the ability to adapt to change and COVID-proof their businesses. I think especially here in Wicklow, I'm delighted you said it, it is really great to see the Student Enterprise Program so well supported by teachers, schools and the parents, of course. I mean, this hasn't been easy over the last couple of months. Sure, it hasn't.
Sure, it hasn't. Not for nobody. Everybody has felt it, and everybody has their own stories and their own struggles and challenges. And for that particular reason, it's even more commendable, you know, that the students have gone on this amazing journey where they come up with an idea, they execute it, they end up with a service or a product that they actually make themselves. And then they brand it, they do their market research, they go on such a journey. And to do that with the background of the lockdowns, not being able to go to school and see your friends and really work in the teams physically, you know, rather than being online. It's just phenomenal.
Well, this time last year, we would have been in a hotel with a live stage packed with students, and we've adapted and moved online. But the reach, we are well over 120, 130 people actually just lying in. So some of the comments are coming through. So Suzanne Carroll saying, best of luck to all the students taking part. Katrina Nolan, best of luck to Loretto Bray. Maria Lynch is joining in there and saying Loretto Bray as well. Alphabetique, so proud of you all. Justin Foley, best of luck to all the schools and students, especially Greystones Community College. What a first year. So we've got Orla Kane jumping out to Glenart. So keep these guys, the comments coming, guys. It's fantastic. Great to see it. And you mentioned Quiz Kids there and Gary and the team. Wishing everyone good luck today, that the standard really was off the charts this year. And I would have hated to be a judge, Vibeke. They must have had a really difficult job.
Oh, they struggled. They struggled. Yes. There was a lot of deliberations going on and backwards and forwards. They were very impressed. Their feedback, they were just blown away by, you know, all the different businesses, the different ideas, the way it was executed. And of course, the videos, you know, we've thoroughly enjoyed watching those. And actually to give a shout out and to thank our judges so much. Our judges were Lisa Cunningham, Niall Glynn and Paul Douglas. So well done, guys. Thank you so much for all the hard work you put into this. And look, we're only looking forward to the outcomes later on.
Well, we're getting to them fairly quickly. And again, thank you to the judges and a great shout out to the guys there. So we'll move it on. And I have the little ticker on the bottom saying that we have not just one, but two really, really special surprise guests. I think we'll go for the first one.
Well, so here we go. Noel?
Yep.
Can I just say thank you to you and the Entrepreneurs Academy as well before you put me in the green room again. Fantastic job. Thanks, guys.
Not at all. No, you're very, very welcome. And it's an absolute pleasure to be involved. And don't worry, I won't keep you in the green room for long, Vibeke.
All right. Thanks.
So we'll see you soon. So let's welcome our very first special guest today.
The first of our mystery guests this afternoon is Wicklow native athlete and European gold medal champion, Fionnuala McCormack. One of Ireland's most accomplished athletes, Fionnuala represents Ireland at the 2007 and 2011 World Championships in Athletics, the 2008 Beijing Olympics, the 2012 London Olympics, and the 2016 Rio Olympics, and also the European Athletics Championships. She won gold medal at the 2011 and 2012 European Cross Country Championships, becoming, in 2012, the first woman ever to successfully defend the European Cross Country Championship.
Is on her way to history. Fionnuala Britain heads for the line. Brilliant, brilliant, Britain wins.
We are absolutely delighted to have a message specifically for you, this year's student enterprise finalists, from Wicklow's own Olympian and European gold medalist, Fionnuala McCormack.
Congratulations on successfully setting up your mini businesses for the student enterprise program. Good luck in the competition. It's a great experience to be part of. When I was your age, I competed in my first European Cross Country Championships in Switzerland. I finished near the back of the field, but I loved running, so I stuck with it. And 10 years later, I won it as a senior. So my advice would be, enjoy what you do, stick with it. And as Samuel Beckett once wrote, ever tried, ever failed. No matter. Try again, fail better.
And thank you, Fionnuala, for those words and a very sunny peak in Wicklow Mountains there, where you hear the birds singing in the background. So thank you for joining the Joys of Technology. So let's kick off with our first set of awards. We're going to go to the junior category, and this is a special commendation award. And let's go straight into it. So the winners of the special commendation awards, they win a €50 one for all voucher. And the first winner is Kalasha Quavon, so RF Bath Salts. And there you can see Rachel there clapping away. So well done. Congratulations to RF Bath Salts. And the next winner there is Greystones Community College with Bonnie Milchan. And there we have Sifra and Hannah. Congratulations. A 50 euro one for all voucher on the way there. And then we have Kalasha Quavon again, a cable tamer. So Leon Kelly. Congratulations, Leon. Well done. And then we're going to go to Greystones Community College. And there's Jaden there. Well done, Jaden. He's having some of his own chocolates, as you can see there, with Java chocolate. So well done and congratulations to you guys. So the nominees in the junior category. We have Greystones Community College with Mascot. We have Colossia Quavon in Twice with Sugar Shack and Pampered Paws. And you can see some of their items there. So we have them clapping as well. There's the technology working. So we've got Mascot there, Sugar Shack and Pampered Paws. So the winner of the Junior Category Award, and you can see the trophy there on the right-hand side, which will be winging its way to you. The winner is Sugar Shack from Colossia Quavon with Usheen Reynolds, Keen O'Brien and Rosie Davis. Congratulations to you all and well done. It's a wonderful achievement and well done for all the work that you've put through. And it's great to be here announcing all the efforts and seeing them in a very unusual way online, but we're going to make the most of it. So congratulations to you. Now, what we said we would do is we'd make this as interactive as possible. So we're going to ask you to get your mobile phones out. We're going to ask you to use them for a live quiz, use them as a second screen. And we have a one for all voucher to the sum of €100 to the winner. So take out your mobile phone and we'll get you to log in. So let me set it up here for you. And I'll throw this up on the screen. And here we go. So we're live and ready. Now, what we'll ask you to do is go to menti.com, M-E-N-T-I.com, and then put in that number, which is 61246259. So if you have your mobile phone with a camera on it and you point it at the screen at the QR code, it'll automatically load in. Or if you then just go to your browser and type in menti.com, M-E-N-T-I.com, and then put in that number, 61246259. We'll give you a few moments to do that. So menti.com 61 24 62 59. And well done, Caitlin, back at base, who's managing all the comments. So if you're on YouTube, you can see it's in the comments there. The code has been put in for you, so you can keep an eye on it. And it'll also stay up on the top of the screen. So on the top of the screen there, you can see it. And we can see all the hearts being tipped on the right hand side, which is great. So we have everyone in. So let's have a quick look. Now, what we're going to ask you to do is, as you've put in your name, a little avatar will pop up. So if you're lucky enough to win, we're going to ask you to identify yourself to your teacher in your school. And then we will be able to get the voucher to you. So we have five questions. And the quicker you answer, the more points you get. So it's kind of like fastest finger first. We have 61 people there entered. All the avatars are on the screen. 63, 64, 65. I'm going to give it another couple of seconds there. Well, I'll move that across so we can see it a little bit easier. Yeah, so we've roughly around 65 people in it. So let's go. Question one. Remember, the faster you answer, the more points you will get. And there is a Wicklow theme to everything. So Wicklow is often referred to as the gateway to Eden, the field of dreams, or the garden of Ireland. The quicker you answer, the more points you get. So three, two, one, time's up. And we've got 59 people who chose the correct answer of the Garden of Ireland. So let's have a quick look and see who was the fastest. So it's one thing to get it right. It's another thing to do it as fast as you possibly can. So here we go. Katie is in the lead at 963, followed by Aoife, Usheen Doyle, Isla Farrell, and Aoife C and Jessica Woods. All really, really tight at the top. So you'll see how now the system works. So let's go on to question two. Again, the quicker you answer, the more points that you will get. Which famous Catherine is from Wicklow? Is it Kate Middleton, Katie Taylor, or Katie Perry? Which famous Catherine is from Wicklow? Three more seconds. Time's up. And the correct answer, of course, is Katie Taylor. The other two just wish they were from Wicklow. So 55 people have got that correct. Let's have a quick look and see what has happened there. Who was the fastest this time? And then how that adds together with the points. So Katie has a bit of competition. There's a few people now that have been much faster, and that will have changed at the top. It has. Aoife C has jumped to the top with 1905. Only Fools and Horseshoes. Love what you did there. Well done. You were the fastest and jumped right into second place with 1900. Jessica Woods, Oisin Dial, Una, Rebecca White, all still there. So let's move on to the third question. So remember, the faster you answer, the more points you get. Here we go. The Happy Pear Cookbook. Happy Pear recipes and stories from the first 10 years contains vegan and vegetarian recipes only. Is that true or is it false? Does it contain vegan and vegetarian recipes only? 3 seconds remaining. Time's up. Oh, and 57 got that correct. Absolutely. It is true, of course. The guys in Greystones with their book, Recipes and Stories from the First 10 Years, is all vegan and vegetarian only. So let's see what happens to our scoreboard now. Who was fast enough on that one? Oh, it's very tight. Very, very tight. So let's see what happens when they're added. And Aoife was fastest. Aoife, well done. You're holding on to a commanding lead there. We're about 19 points there at the top from Only Fools and Horse Boxes. Oisin Dial, Rebecca White, Conor McCarthy, Sophie Hamilton and Ruth. Well done. So you're all in with a shout because we have two more questions remaining. So here's the second last one. Question 4 of 5. Faster you are, the more points you get. Lugan na Cuile is the highest mountain in Wicklow. But what is its correct height? Is it 821 metres, 931 metres or 1001 metres? Lugan na Cuile, the highest mountain in Wicklow. What is its correct height? Let's have a quick look. 37 people went for 931 metres and they are correct. Now that will change a few things. So let's see what happens next. We'll have a quick look and see who the fastest finger was. Only Fools and Horse Boxes is there. Laura Allen's there. Jessica Woods was the fastest and she jumps up. But we've got Only Fools and Horse Boxes taking the lead over at 3818. 3812 is Oisin Dial. Sophie Hamilton's still there. Heather and Ruth are still there. And it's getting pretty tight. So we come to our final question. And it's a music question. Again, with a Wicklow theme. Answer fast to get more points. What is the missing lyric from the Hozier song? And so I fall in love just a little, oh, just a little blank, with someone new. Fill in the blank. Is it way, day, or moment? Let's have a quick look. And 50 people have gone for day and they are absolutely correct. And for those of you who want to make sure that that's going to stay in your head for the rest of the day, here's Hozier. So let's see the last question and the winner of the €100 one for all voucher. Let's have a quick look. Who was the fastest? What happens to the points? Let's see where this goes. They're adding up. And we have a winner. And it's Oisin Dial. Well done, Oisin. You got it there at the very end. You were the fastest person there. Congratulations. You are the winner of a €100 voucher. If you contact your teacher, they'll make arrangements to get that to you. But I did mention that we had a really, really special guest. There was a clue in the quiz. I can't believe we're going to announce him. He's here and he's live. It's Jose.
Hey, it's Hosier here. I just wanted to offer the best of luck to everybody taking part in the Student Enterprise Awards and offer you my admiration and respect for taking part in the Enterprise Programme. The skills that you've developed over the last while are ones that you will take with you through the rest of your life, and you will take those skills into new and emerging and exciting markets and into new and important relationships in business. So it's a fantastic use of your time. It's a wonderful thing to develop those skills, to flex those muscles, and it will stand to you forever. So well done, congratulations, and well done to everybody who helped make the program happen. It's an incredible thing. Best of luck, and I will see you down the line. Bye.
Thank you to Jose for those words, and the connections in the local enterprise office know no bounds, do they? Not from Bray, as many people think. It's from Newcastle in County Wicklow. And we wish him the very best with a very tough year for most musicians, where they've had to pivot and change their offering. And we're going to talk to a couple of business people today, but I have great pleasure to bring in Kevin Ward, sales manager of Reward Catering. So let's introduce Kevin. Reward Catering is based in Rathnew. It's the brainchild of Tom and Kevin Ward. The company manufactures and fits out purpose-built catering trailers and food trucks for the catering community. Their trucks are used by clients for a wide range of sales and promotional purposes, such as coffee trailers, cocktail and gin bars, pizza trailers, and corporate branded mobile kitchens and booths. Founded in 2018, and despite the challenges of COVID, the company has grown exponentially over the last 3 years, and now selling in Ireland, UK, Europe, and plans for the US. We're joined by sales manager Kevin Ward to learn and to hear from their entrepreneurial journey. So we'll ask you to give a warm reception to Kevin.
Thanks for having me on the show.
How are you?
Brilliant. Thanks for having me on.
Now you're following Hosier. How do you do that?
I haven't a clue.
No pressure. No pressure whatsoever. Do you know, when I saw the video there, I as a child used to watch NASA launch rockets to the moon and satellites in the space. And whenever there was astronauts going to the pad, they traveled in one of those airstreams, didn't they? So for those that don't know, describe what an airstream is.
Yeah, so you would be right. The very, very iconic in the 60s, 70s in the US. They would have been used as campers, used on film sets, used for pretty much anything. So they were very, very popular, and they kind of have a nostalgic feel about them. So they're very popular over the last number of years with people looking to expand their outdoor offering, or whether it's they want to market their business. So it's very, very popular.
So there is a bespoke one being put into the baths in Clontarf, and they are. Where did the inspiration come for them? I mean, where did you see these? I mean, it was a long journey to where you are now. But where did the inspiration for these come from?
Well, we would have had an ice cream kiosk in Bray, and we looked to expand to mobile offering. And one option that we considered was renovating an old airstream. However, the time and getting feedback from other people who have done that, it's a lot of headaches involved. So we just started our own quest and started manufacturing our units.
And from an entrepreneur point of view, we've got well over 100 people watching the stream. So they all are exploring the option of being an entrepreneur. So did you always dream of being an entrepreneur and running your own business, or was it something that you just fell into?
I suppose I would have always had an ambition to be some sort of a business owner, to be some entrepreneur. never knew exactly what I wanted to do, but it was always something that you had in the back of your mind. So one thing I'd say is, you know, even if it's a plan that you have and things haven't kicked into place straight away, you know, it's not a race. You know, you don't need to, as soon as you're finished college or as soon as you're finished school, to have that brilliant idea and get started. You know, eventually, if you keep working at it, you'll come up with the right idea or the right method to get exactly where you want to go to.
So coming up with the idea, I know you've used social media to a really interesting and innovative way. And I suppose the one of the questions I wanted to ask, because I know that you use it in a very market research centric way, what research did you do to make sure there was a market for the product?
Yes, so we would have spent a number of months, and also with help from the Enterprise Board. You know, obviously it can be quite expensive to do research and getting everything set up, especially when there's no revenue coming in, and you're spending a lot of money to do so. So yeah, we did a lot of market research in terms of surveys. We did some post advertisements, so we spent a lot of money on the advertisement side of things before we invested heavily into the production of the units. So it kind of gave us the right feedback that we were working in the right direction. But I would say, you know, the Enterprise Board do help out massively. I know they have a couple of different incentives and programs to help people, like feasibility studies. And, you know, if you have a really good idea, you're not alone. You can get help off the guys who just want to see you succeed. So they've been nothing but helpful to ourselves. So thanks very much to the Enterprise Board.
I can see Vibiger in the green room is waving back at you there now and saying, you know, welcome back, because you are a poster child from a business point of view of using the available supports that are there. Now, it has been a very tough year. In that little video there, we've seen that it was at a trade show where people can see the product. So what has been the most challenging part of being in business over the last year or 18 months and as a result of the pandemic?
Yeah, I suppose it's a lot like other businesses. Being able to pivot and being able to change quite quickly and adapt. I'd probably say, you know, if anything, the pandemic is going to give a lot of people a lot of new skills. You know, like, for example, we would have two parts of our business. One would be for the manufacturing and sales, but then we also had a department that would do with rentals and leases for a number of different projects. So I suppose when the pandemic started, that side of the business went out the door. The revenue went from you know, X to zero, you know, in the space of a couple of days, like most businesses. But I suppose it was taking the time to make a decision on what to pivot towards. So we put all of the guys into sales. You know, we reached out to a lot of companies who were looking to do outdoor offerings. You know, quickly identified that, you know, you couldn't have your bars open without restaurants, etc. So yeah, it's just being able to adapt. You know, if you have the right skills, you can adapt to something that suits to keep the business thriving onwards.
So many of the students would have delved into a couple of new skills, and marketing is it's really important, as you know. You can have the most amazing business on the planet. If nobody knows about it, you have no business. So what kind of marketing incentives have you used, and have you embraced social media?
Yes, well, not personally. I don't actually use any social media. As you probably noticed, Noel, you can't find any photos of me. But yeah, it's key. Absolutely. It's probably the number one priority that business should be focusing. You know, I've looked at some of the projects the guys have done, and amazing ideas that I've done. But, you know, if it's not marketed correctly, no one will know about the products or services that they're offering. So yeah, Thomas, my brother, he you know, he has a background in IT. He's worked for a couple of large multinational companies, and that would be, I suppose, he's expertise. So he would look after all of the marketing. You know, it's definitely key to everything. You know, keeping active on your social media platforms, updating your website regularly, and having a good SEO team then as well. So very important.
And one of my favorite questions to ask anybody is, we've all been on a journey through life. So when you look back to the age that a lot of our finalists are today, 14, 15, 16 years of age, what advice would you give yourself, your younger self? Looking back, what would be the best thing that you could say to our audiences watching today?
I suppose, as I said, not to rush. Take every little achievement, whether it's big or small, but even the small achievements, be proud of them small achievements, because they're the steps to where you want to go. And kind of a mentality that I've built because of being in sales, not to be taking everything, all the negatives on board. Without getting negatives, you're never going to get your positive results. So every negative brings you closer to the result that you need. So a little motto I always say in my head is, some will, some won't, so what, and who's next? So it's just about having like a goldfish memory. When something negative happens, let that, forget about that as quickly as possible. Even throughout the days or weeks, even if it's not to do with business, even if it's to do with your own personal mental health, write down something positive from each day. And when you're feeling a bit down, you can flick back through your book and see all the positive things from that day. And then you just get back into your positive mindset.
Yeah, and celebrate successes. You touched on something there, Kevin, which is really important. Failure is part of the game. We forget that, when setting up and running a business, nothing goes right all the time. And it's how we learn. When we learn to walk, we take two or three steps and we fall over and we pick ourselves up and learn how to balance. Running a business is very much like that, Kevin. And how do you deal with the disappointments?
Yeah, it's just being prepared for them, understanding that they are part of the structure, part of moving forward. You're never going to learn things unless you make mistakes. It's just literally embracing them. You're not learning anything if you're not making mistakes. You're never going to get where you want to go if you're afraid of making the mistakes.
Yeah, and if we don't embrace that fear of failure and getting things wrong, we never come up with anything new. So well said, Kevin. I'm going to bring in Vibeke again, because you actually spoke about some of the supports that the company availed of. Vibeke, an amazing business with Kevin, isn't it?
Absolutely stunning. I love them. I love the, your catering trucks, Kevin. They when they pass on the road, or if you see them parked somewhere, they're so eye catching. And we're delighted to have you as our client, and we're delighted to have supported you on this business journey and to see you doing so well. We have a huge range of supports, as you know, Noel, and we would just encourage anybody to come and talk to us, and then we take it from there, and we signpost to where other supports are through other agencies, or we help with whatever supports are applicable at that particular time. And we help startups, established businesses, most businesses under 10, or actually all businesses under 10 employees should have a chat with us, and we take the journey from there.
And I think Kevin touched on it there, Vibeke, that it is important to reach out for help when setting up a business. So for the students that are here and waiting for the final results to come out here on the Student Enterprise Program, some will be very happy, some will be a little bit disappointed, but that's not the end of the role, isn't it? It's important to reach out, and the local authority through its local enterprise office has a really important role to play in supporting young people that have ideas for businesses, because you want to create an environment where businesses can flourish, can't you?
Absolutely. And that's kind of the sole objective of this whole program, is to foster entrepreneurship and to foster that at a very young age, that we don't all have to go to college, or you could go to college and then start your business. As Kevin says, there's no rush, there's no competition. You do it whenever it suits you, but hopefully this program will give you the bug to think about it as an option to set up work for yourself and be your own boss. And, everybody here, all the students that came to the county final, you're all finalists, and you've all been on a journey and learned so, so much without even realizing that all the steps you've taken between from September till now, to, you know, to set up your own business, first of all, to realize your idea, to do your market research, to reach out to your community and ask them to buy from you and advertise and tell your story, either through social media, or if you don't like social media like Kevin, you do it in other ways. But, you know, to be mindful that maybe your markets are on social media. So, yeah, there's many ways. But just to realize that all of you today, you've learned skills, Hosier said it as well, that you'll be using for the rest of your life. And we want to help you with that if you do decide to set up your own business. So come and talk to us.
Well, before we let you go, Kevin, we were taking comments and I said, how do you follow on from Hosier? Well, quite a few people actually think that you look like Ed Sheeran. So there you go. So there's a theme here as well. Well, there you are. Kevin, thank you so much for joining us and for your words of wisdom. And stay around in the green room as we announce the winner. So thank you very much.
Thanks very much, Noel. Thanks, Vibeke. Thanks, guys.
So, Vibeke, we're at the business end of things now. So we're going to get on to the next stage of the awards. So the senior category, we have the Special Commendation Award. So would you like to announce the winner of the Special Commendation Award?
I can't wait. Let's go. So the winner of the Special Commendation Award is... Toads to Go, Ariana, Neve, Allison, and Fozia from Loretta Secondary School in Bray. Well done, guys. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Toads to Go. And there we can see a selection of some of your offerings there. And the skill on the craft end of things has been huge. We often see crafts each year, but it really is sustainability and upskilling and upcycling. We're seeing a bit of a trend on it, more sustainability. So well done to Ariane, Neve, Alison and Fajra for Totes to Go. Well, so the next one then in the senior category is the Innovation Award.
Yes, so move on. And the Innovation Award winner is... Innovative, Lucy Durfel and Roisin from the North Wicklow Educate Together School.
Congratulations. So instead of innovative, we've got Pinnovative, and you can see there some of their pins they've done. They're absolutely stunning, they're beautiful. And well done, Lucy Durfel and Roisin. So congratulations. We move on then to the senior category, Best Video Presentation. And we should say that there is, as well with a trophy, there's a one for all voucher of €100 to each of the winners that we're announcing at the moment. So the Best Video Presentation.
Okay, so Best Video Presentation, we thoroughly enjoyed watching this video. We enjoyed all of them, but this one really has to be the winner. So without further ado, the winner of the Best Video Presentation goes to Biscuit Bear Prince.
Congratulations, Sophie Hamilton.
From Colastic Fawn in Kilcool. Well done.
And I think we actually have a selection of our video here.
Hello. Oh, wait. No, this is horrible. Wrong form. Sorry, give me a minute.
And hopefully that's better. Hi, my name is Sophie and I own the mini company of Biscuit Bear Prince. My company specializes in making art prints as such, and I also make my own little pins like so. I decided to do art prints and pins for my mini company because I have a massive passion for drawing and creating, but also they're pretty simple gifts to give. You can give them for any occasion, which could be weddings, birthdays, or even graduations. I am now gonna pass you on to my animated self, who's gonna talk you through a few
COVID
things.
Has made things so hard for everyone. It's made even the simplest of tasks, like going out to get gifts, very difficult, especially when you're in and out of lockdown and restrictions are all over the place and you're not really sure what's going on. My product and my company as a whole aims to make gift giving a lot more personalized and simple, especially during these times. What's really good about my product and my company is how customizable it is. Art can be anything. I can draw anything you want as long as you give me a reference. For an example, say you ordered a commission off me of you and your girlfriend for Valentine's Day. Here's an example of what that print might turn out to be. It's covered with this seal to protect it just in case you get caught up in some rain. It is Ireland after all. Now, for my pins, they're a bit smaller, so they're a bit harder to work with. But this is an example of what you might get. So I do a pack of 4 pins for 3 euro. This is an example of the packaging. It has my logo at the back, and then the 4 pins of your choice. I have
some stunning editing there. So that was speaking to camera is one of the most difficult things to do. So many people, you and I know, Vibhika, have that fear. It's called glossophobia, yeah. The fear of public speaking. And to see people going in front of the camera and animation and describing the product so well, stunning, wasn't it?
So good, Sophie. You're very talented. We can't wait to see your next animation. Keep it up and keep going. Absolutely brilliant.
So well done to Sophie. So we move on to the next award, which is the excellent product or service in the senior category.
Yeah, so can't wait to announce this one, though. The winner of the excellent product or service is Huang Tusong, Oshin, Aaron, Josh and Dara from St. Kevin's Community College. Well done, guys. Congratulations.
Well done, St. Kevin's. And there's Kron Tushan, and there's the guys, Oshin, Aaron, Josh and Dara. So well done. And there's a little sample of your wares there to laughter your photographs. So congratulations and well done. The Innovative Sales Award.
Yeah, again, lovely product. So without further ado, the winner of the Innovative Sales Award is Masquerade, Juliet from Clash Street, Carnoux.
Congratulations, Juliet and Masquerade. I think that's, and there she is there clapping away. She's delighted with herself. So brilliant. A great play on the name there, Masquerade. And well done, Juliet. And a super, and you can actually see the masks there on the left-hand side. And this has been a reaction to the last couple of months and what we've been going through. So it's great to see innovation pivoting to problems that we need solved. So, and she's still cheering. There she is there. So let's go to the social media award.
Yeah, before we move on, I just want to say lovely, colorful designs. Really love to wear one of those masks. So I'm going to look you up, Juliet, and see if you have online sales. Next one, social media awards. The winner of this category is Acrene Accessories. Nicole, Kate, Isabel, Ruth, and Ava of Loretta Secondary School in Bray. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Loretto Secondary School and Akron Accessories. And there we have Nicole, Kate, Isabel, Ruth, and Ava. And very colourful products there, as you can see. So well done, guys. Loving the logo as well, by the way. So I'm dying to know where Akron came from. I'd say it's an anagram of all their names. So well done. It's brilliant. The Intellectual Property Awareness Award. Something that's really important. So protecting your idea and protecting your innovation. So would you announce the winner of the Intellectual Property Awareness Award?
I will, of course. And a great pleasure to announce the winner of this award in this category, which goes again to Kron Tusan.
Congratulations to Oshin, Aaron, Josh and Dara. So well done, as well as creating something they were very much aware of, protecting it and the intellectual property around it. So well done, guys. Congratulations. Now, we have a little bit of a break because we wanted to honour the teachers and give a quick shout out to all the teachers that have worked so hard. So as a token of that, we have a spot prize, a 100 euro voucher. And what we've done is we've got all the teachers' names and we've put them on a wheel and we're going to give it a spin to find the winner of a 100 euro voucher. So here we go. All the teachers are there on the wheel and we'll give it a quick spin to find our winner. So best of luck to all the teachers. Let's see how this goes. Is it Patricia? Is it Emma? It is Emma. It stayed on your name there. There we go. Congratulations, Emma Page. You are the winner of that 100 euro voucher. And that is just a token thank you to all the teachers that have worked so hard on behalf of all your students. So we come to the tail end of the awards. And before we go to this, I'm going to go run into the comments because we have loads of people now that are shouting out for their school and their friends. So go Loretta Ray, Alison's there. And amazing work, Quiz Kids are there saying so. Absolutely, well done, Arkin, and well done, Loretta Bray, for your win so far. We've got a few. Billy Corcoran's shouting there, give it to Miss Keane, give it to Miss Keane. It's the wheel, Billy. That's all we can do. We can put the names on the wheel and see what happens, you know. So congratulations to Emma Page on that one. So we'll go to the final run through of the awards. So the senior category winners and their trophies are there. They'll be ready to send to them.
Yep.
So let's move on. So we have the runner up in the senior category.
So we have two runners up in the this category in no particular order. Our two runners up are Masquerades. Again, Juliet from Class to Breathe. Well done, Juliet.
There, she's still raving her hands in the air. So well done, Juliet. That's super. Well done. And our second runner up is?
Our second runner up is Positively Delicious Recipes by Jamie from CBS Arclo.
Well done, Jamie Tobin. So there we are. And there he is with his recipe book. Well done, Jamie. Congratulations on that one.
Well done. Gorgeous book. Lovely.
So our senior category winner.
This is what it's all about. Their overall winner. And just to say that the winners of both the junior and the senior categories will go on to represent Wicklow at the national finals in May. So just as a reminder, I go on now. The winner is Simple Signpost. So well done. Congratulations to Nadia, Heidi and Hillary of East Landerlock School.
And fabulous, we can see booklet. A sample of the wares there. So it's congratulations to Simple Signpost, Nadia, Heidi and Hillary. So we have, I think, quite a few people in the room. And we see if we can get them to give a quick clap and see if, with the power of technology, see will this work. And here they are. Yeah, we have them. Absolutely.
Wow, that's fab. Great. Well done, Simple Signpost. So deserved. Really, really great project.
So while they couldn't be with us live, we've got them as virtual as we possibly can. Vibeke, a quick word for the people that are a little bit disappointed that they didn't win something, and then the next step for the winners as they move on.
Well, congratulations to all of you. You're all finalists, and every single one of you should be so proud of what you've achieved on this business journey. And all the steps, the teamwork, the telling your story, just, you know, battling on through adversity and challenges and sticking with us. You're just fab. And we're so proud of you all. So congratulations to the winners and to the finalists. And just very lastly to say thank you, Noel. Thank you to the judges, the teachers, the students, the parents, to Annette in the Leo team, to Gary and Hannah in Whiskits, and also to everybody who participated here today and all the great comments. Keep them up. Keep them going. Keep Twittering or Facebook and whatever you do, Instagram. And of course, the winners go on to represent County Wicklow at the national finals in May. So we'd love to see you all again there. And I can't wait. Go Wicklow. Go Team Wicklow. And thank you again, Noel. Super fabulous ceremony.
Our pleasure. So go Team Wicklow. We wish you the very best in the national finals in May. Thank you to everyone. Look after yourselves. We wish you the very best. Keep innovating, keep safe, keep positive, and we'll see you soon. Thank you very much.